With the MLB draft already underway, a young prospect shares his expectations with a former coach.
Carlos, you lived that in your baseball career. What's this world like?
Oh, it's extremely exciting. You know that if you perform, you will get the call.
We've got a developing story here. JP, what are you hearing?
I'm checking the numbers. I'm talking to my sources and my scouts, and they're all telling me, hey, this could actually work.
Most of us mere mortals, when we were that age, we were barely chewing gum and walking at the same time, let alone playing the hardest game there is.
That Sammy's pumping up mentally here to adapt. That's what good players do.
That dream of getting the big leagues is now becoming reality with that one phone call.
Continuing our MLB Draft Day 2 wrap-up coverage, back to the prospect that we mentioned before the break. There was some surprise, even some criticism of the front office over how early he went off the board. Jonathan Mayo, what do you think of this pick?
Man, I don't think any of us saw this one coming. This definitely feels like a reach to me. I had him more as a day three kind of guy. There was a split camp. A lot of scouts disagreed whether he's better as a pitcher or better as a hitter. I'm guessing the team felt that he's got potential on both sides of the ball, and maybe that adds some value to him. But this made me scratch my head a little bit for sure.
All right, Jonathan Mayo, thanks. What about you, Jim Callis? Was this a head-scratcher or the reach of the draft, as some of the other analysts have suggested?
Yeah, you know, I talked to somebody with the team, and they're excited to get this guy. This is a guy they really want. And the two points the club made to me were, one, you know, this whole debate, is he a hitter, is he a pitcher? You know, what are you going to do with him? There was a lot of confusion. This team isn't confused. This team feels like he's got very good potential as a hitter and as a pitcher. They may even try to play him both ways. And they felt like there were a couple other teams that were starting to sniff around this guy. And, you know, this isn't the NFL or NBA draft where you can trade down to get a guy you want. If you want a guy, you have to take him because there's no trades. And they felt like if they didn't take him where they did, somebody else was going to get them. And they just absolutely did not want that to happen.
Jim Callis, we appreciate the time. Thanks.
A minor league manager checks in with one of his players to discuss a launch plan for the young man's development.
Rolling along with the podcast and back on the prospect who's divided the scouting community, I am opposed to this belief that he went too high. I really think he could be a steal here. This is a guy who's got so much development left to do. He's got so much potential. And I think all the scouts who are down on him think, oh, he's not a finished product. We don't know what he is. That, to me, could be a good thing. He can hit. He can field. He can pitch. There is so much untapped potential so far for this guy. I'm excited to see what he becomes. And certainly as he gets started actually playing, actually being in games, we're going to be able to talk to some other folks who get a better read on him and see what they think. I'm excited for that. And frankly, I'm going to have my eye on him for a while.
Striding in is LT Tolbert. He'll get us started in this one under
leading
the
off
lights
here tonight. the
first second pitch of the AB now. And the new season is finally upon us as the first pitch of the new year is taken here for ball one. Well, you don't need us to tell you. It's really starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Yeah, Matt, right now this doesn't look too good. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see the umpires come out and bring the ground crew out here. The infield around the mound and around the home plate area is really getting soaking wet. And I can't anticipate this going on very much longer.
Now here's the pitch. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Here's another 1-2. Fouled away. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone.
Boy, not what you want coming out of the gate as a pitcher, right? You don't want to have to show all of your pitches this early on in the game, but that's a quality at bat. And what does it make you do as a pitcher? You have to use a lot of your pitches, and the more pitches a hitter sees, the better chance they have to make good contact.
Up next, Andy Yerzy.
Batting second, the first baseman. Andy.
Now the first pitch. A high fastball is in there.
One's the count.
You know, a lot of guys don't like to swing at the first pitch. That might be the case with this one right here. Took a wheelhouse fastball, 0-0 center cut.
Hey,
didn't
away,
even give the impression he was swinging.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
And he struck him out. And as he punches him out there, he collects his first double-A strikeout.
Well, I'm sure that feels good, and maybe he'll keep the ball or something. But you know his sights are set on a lot higher than double-A ball. Figuring out how to strike out a lot more guys at this level as he progresses in the minors will be one of the keys for him reaching the big leagues.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. Now to the plate, here is Alec Thomas. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Thomas.
That's popped up. Posey in foul ground, but this will land untouched.
No one out now.
Ready with the nothing in one pitch.
Hey, that's a heck of a pitch right there. If he's able to execute with that type of velocity, fastballs up and in,
I can't imagine.
That's a hit, their first of the new season.
Relay, it'll kick around
in the corner.
He'll pull into
second here with nobody out.
That was some great situational hitting there after surveying the field to see what the defense was giving him. The third baseman was well off the line, and he had no chance to make a play as he sprays it down the left field line for a two-bagger.
He's set. Here's the 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Oh, I love this, boys. Mano y mano. He's coming to get him with back-to-back big-time heaters.
Bounce to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself for the first out, but it's a productive one as the runner moves up to third. So stepping in is Cooper Hummel. Potential time run for him at third base. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Here we go, boy.
That's up. A man at third with one away. Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third.
That strikeout changes the whole complexion of the inning. He was definitely pitching for it with a runner on third and one out, and he got it. Now it's going to take a hit or something like a wild pitch to get that guy home.
In now, Blaze Alexander, as he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Runner in scoring position with two gone. swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing in two. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
Hey, that's back-to-back really good sliders. I wouldn't be surprised if he threw another one right here. Looks like he's got that slide ball in his back pocket right now.
And 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Base hit, and that'll get a run in.
Hey, there's a good job of battling right there, D-Roll. Pitcher have the advantage with two outs, two strikes. You're one pitch away, and boy, what a terrific piece of hitting right there.
Yeah, that's a great job right there. Some guys are not afraid to hit with two strikes. They'll take that pitcher deep in the count, feeling comfortable about it. That's the type of hitter this guy is, and he was able to come through.
Batting eight, the third baseman, Frank Askew.
At the plate now, Frank Askew. Lays off 1-0. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Alexander is off a first with two away. And that misses 2-1. Runners off for second. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get this. Now to the plate, the pitcher, A-Rom
Batting
Big Daddy.
The pitcher, A-Ray Big Daddy.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Strike one to start the at-bat. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Line drive to left. And the pitcher's got to
make
a
turn, pick up the
hit.
Ball.
Hey, don't let the fact that this guy's on the mound fool you right here. This guy has a nice approach at the plate, knows what he's doing, has history. I'm not surprised he was able to mix in a base knock.
So the batting
now
order
batting.
Turns over
left
now.
Fielder.
And set to go, Zach Rex. He doubled his last time up. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. DeLuzio comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for out number two. Next up is Omar Estevez.
Now
he went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Omar.
Ready on 0-2. Goes down to get this thing as this is
round
lifted
hard,
in the air to straightaway left.
You're scoring.
And the two out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. All set for the start of the inning and set to go as the third baseman, Frank Askew.
Frank.
And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
Here it comes on nothing and two.
Inside ball.
And he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2.
Stone cold take right there. That fastball very well could have sent him packing back to the bench.
Another 1-2 delivery. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. So next to hit is LT Tolbert trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. No balls and one strike. 0-1, here's the pitch. A shot to first base and caught there to end the inning. Stepping in once again is Andy Yerzy, a as we begin the top of the fourth. And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
Shocked he didn't let it fly right there. Usually you're looking for a fastball elevated to get the party started.
Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Andy Yerzy becomes the first out of the inning. Ben DeLuzio will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
No, inside.
Slider is laid off on the inside as it just misses the zone.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think he got a shot to stay inside that one.
To two balls and two strikes now.
There, one down, that one down.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. So here's the cleanup hitter, Alec Thomas, will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning.
Hey, he's looking to punch out the side right here. And if this guy's going to do him favors and swing outside the zone, that's exactly what's going to happen.
Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one in. Next to hit will be the pitcher.
Number 36.
Big Daddy singled in his last at bat.
Big Daddy.
He's set and the pitch.
All right, come on now. One time, let it fly.
And there's ball one. Swing and a hard liner to center field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Now at the plate, Dom Arroyo. He'll start off the fifth in this one. Here's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
Hey, this guy's nasty on the mound, and a check swing and not chase that one puts himself right back in the count.
In there at the letters, one and
two
now.
The count is one and two.
And he punches out another one, make it nine for the ball game.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Cooper Hummel stands in as he looks at a called strike. Called strike, 0-2.
Two well-executed pitches at the knees right there, but I know this hitter's looking for something up.
Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away.
That's 10 strikeouts for him now, and I'll tell you, he could rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Stepping in now, Blaze Alexander. And his first pitch misses to him. It's ball one. One for one with a single so far. And he comes back with one in there for a high strike.
One and one.
Hey, that's a heck of a pitch right there. Big velocity up and in for a strike, too. I mean, you saw this guy flinch at the plate. He was thinking that buzzed the tower, but then to get it popped to strike is tough.
The 1-2. A bouncer up the middle. Scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. New inning set to get underway, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Frank Askew. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one. Good curveball there, gets the swing and miss.
Man, this guy's really pitched well so far, attacking the strike zone, and he's really kept these hitters off balance.
Fielded cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
And this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
Slade Ciccone is at the plate now, and he takes a called strike. Comes back with a fastball up and away that swung on and missed. 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame. So the lineup flips over and digging in, LT Tolbert. He has flied and lined out in two trips in this one. And now the first pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Yeah, if he's going to pound the zone with this stuff all game, the offense better.
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Number 63 is ready, and he'll take the ball. 3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Number 68 claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, click over to theshow.com.
They left 8 men on base.
Pitching coach offers advice to a new member of his staff. Center fielder, number 9, Nick Heath.
Hit on the ground out to short. And that gets through for a one-out base hit.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there.
Stepping in next, Dom Marullio. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going.
Marullio.
Ready with the 1-2. Hit on the ground toward the left. He's got it. Throw to third. And the throw will not get him at third as he moves up on the ground ball. Throw won't be in time. As he digging in, switch hitter, A-Rom, Big Daddy. No one aboard for him. And two gone here in the first. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Center fielder on the run. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. So now into the box is Blaze Alexander. Couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. Slow roller out to short. He's right there. And safe, says the first base umpire, as the throw was too late. Digging in will be Aaron Big Daddy. He's 0-1 thus far.
They've got the gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about it.
Dig.
You have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at bat at a time.
And now here is A-Rom, Big Daddy. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
And it's fouled away. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed for strike number two.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power, let it eat.
Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Another payoff pitch. Full count still. So the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Matt Davidson. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Swinging a blooper to the right side. In there.
Right here, right here.
The relay. And they'll slap the tag on him here in the rundown between second and third. Leading off the inning, it'll be Aaron McDaddy. They'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Come on, guys. Get this ready.
Pulled toward right center field. Keith is there, and he has it for the first out. This one comes to a close with a 9-5 final. The Amarillo Sod Poodles took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end.
Double-A hitting coach touches base with a new arrival to the team.
Looking to put them ahead early with this at bat.
Big Daddy.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Reined in.
Fly.
On to first, and they get the double play. Next to bat will be Nick Heath. First shot batting for him here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. Swing and a liner. But the shortstop's got him played perfectly as he takes this in for the third out. Next to stand in is Aaron McDaddy, 0-1 for him here in this one. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. That's in there on the outer half, 1-2
now.
One out, nobody on. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. And there are two away now. At the plate now is Rene Martinez. Struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Martinez.
Hard hit ball to short. Scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Next to dig in, Aaron Big Daddy. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Lifted in the air out to center field.
Come on, you're scoring.
And he'll pull this one down a step or two in front of the warning track, and the inning is... Next, it'll be Aaron Big Daddy. He flew out in his last debut.
Almost, Maddie. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Hey, see the rip.
The 0-1 pitch. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. Takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Yeah, fine. If you're patient, huh? They can come to you.
Now the 2-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
Here we go.
Here now the 2-2. Lifted down the line and left. Espino is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. And now in the box,
Nick
Heath. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
And he'll put this away for the second out. And stepping in, Blaze Alexander. It was a backwards K, strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit.
4-2 with the final score tonight. Tulsa rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Clayton Beter gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Brian Fernandez earns the save out of the bullpen, his first of the year. So that'll just about do it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of Game's Future Stars are on. Played is Aram Big Daddy comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Bouncer to the left side.
Hold on, right here.
Through into left, a base hit. The throw home. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Swinging a looper to left.
Make the turn.
Find the ball. And no one can get there as it falls. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. Digging in next, Luke Raley. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. Swing and a miss, and that's a much-needed first out there.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. Now to the plate, Carlos Rincon. Given the situation, he's got an opportunity to break this game wide open. And this is swung on and missed. Oh, a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now. Stepping up is number six. He did not play last night, but clearly back in the starting nine for this one. Yerzy calls for it, and that will end the inning.
That boy.
So next to bat will be Aram Big Daddy. He singled in his first AB.
Big Daddy.
From the belt, kicks and deals. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. In there, and it's even at one.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
You're going.
Is gonna get down for extra bases. Make the turn. Get one, if not both of them home. And they've got him hung up out there between second and third. And he is hung out to dry as they... bottom of the inning now. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Alec Thomas.
The left fielder.
Hey, Maddie, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
And a good throw gets him one gone. Next, it'll be Aram Big Daddy. He doubled his last time up.
And I don't know if he's getting waved around by his third base coach right there, but either way, this guy's not a burner. So I think in hindsight, they would have been real happy if he pulled up at second on that one.
Hey, it's nearly impossible to turn two with a guy that could run like this. It's even harder when he comes out of the box hitting from the left side. You really need something tailor-made to even have a chance to get him at first.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Keith is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. Into the box, Aram Big Daddy flew out last time up.
Almost, Maddie, almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Curveball, swing and a miss, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Now to bat, Ben DeLuzio. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Nothing across here this half of the... Next, here is Aram Big Daddy, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if he's stuck.
Oh, and he has some trouble with it. The throw to the plate. Quickly get it in here to hold that runner at third base.
Boy, Dero, we're looking at a big inning right here with that single. Bases are loaded, yet no runs have scored in this inning.
Yeah, and that's exactly what that pitcher wants you to say. You have to eliminate the noise, Dan. Just try and drive in the guy from third base. Don't put pressure on yourself that you have to get everyone in with one swing of the bat. Pass the baton and keep the line moving.
Here we go. Give you right here.
And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. Gone! It's a grand slam.
And it's almost unfair. He inherited this play. Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
8-3 tonight. The Thrillers jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Jose Taveras gets the win on the mound, his first of the year.
No error.
Patrick Hills works two full innings in relief.